Welcome back. In this video, we will focus on the shape of graphs of polynomial functions. In practice, you will most often work with polynomials of degree 2 and lower. Let us look at those separately. The easiest non-zero polynomial functions are those of degree 0. Is that possible? Yes, we can write these functions as px equal to a times x to the power 0. Now remember that x to the power 0 is just 1, so these are just constant functions. The graphs of these functions are simply horizontal lines. Let's make this a bit more exciting by passing to degree 1. Degree 1 polynomials have the form px equal to ax plus b, where a and b are constants. The graph of a degree 1 polynomial function is a straight line, and that's why these functions are also called linear functions. By the way, also constant functions are example of linear functions. If you consider the graph, the coefficients a and b actually have a meaning. A represents the increase of the function value if x increases by 1. As such, it is a measure for the steepness of the graph, called the slope. B is precisely the height of the intersection point of the graph and the vertical axis. It's called the y-intercept. For example, let's look at the graph of the linear function px equal to minus 1/2 x plus 2. Indeed, you see from the graph that the slope equals minus 1/2 and the y-intercept equals 2. It's surprising how many dependencies between everyday quantities can be modeled by linear functions. You will see examples of such dependencies in the exercises. Okay, let's go one degree up to functions of degree 2. These are called quadratic functions. They occur in many applications. For example, if you throw a ball, both the height as a function of time and the trajectory of the ball can be well described by quadratic functions. A very different example is the main cable of a suspension bridge, such as the Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco. In many cases, the shape of these cables can be approximated by a quadratic function. The standard form of a quadratic function is px equal to a times x squared plus bx plus c, where a, b and c are constants. Let's have a look at the graph of such functions. The shape of the graph of any quadratic function is a parabola. It has precisely one extremum, called the vertex, and it is symmetric in the vertical line through this vertex. The relation between the coefficients a, b and c on the one hand and the shape of the graph on the other is not as clear as in the case of linear functions. However, we can at least say the following. A is a measure for the wideness and orientation of the parabola. If a is positive, the parabola opens upward. If it is negative, it opens downward. Also, the closer a to zero, the wider the parabola. Furthermore, the x-coordinate of the vertex of the parabola is located at x equal to minus b divided by 2a. And finally, c again gives the y-intercept of the graph. Let me show you an example. Px equal to 1/2 times x squared minus 3x plus 5 over 2. Indeed, you see that the graph opens upward. The x-coordinate of the vertex equals minus b over 2a and the y-intercept equals the constant term. As we mentioned, you can write any polynomial in standard form. But when it comes to quadratic polynomials, there are at least two other forms that are also very useful. The first is the factorized form, a times x minus p times x minus q, where a, p and q are constants. The advantage of this form is that it tells you a lot about the shape of the graph. A again gives information about the wideness of the parabola and whether it opens upward or downward. P and Q are precisely the x-coordinates of intersection points with the horizontal axis. The polynomial function in our example can be rewritten as 1/2 times x minus 1 times x minus 5. Indeed, you see that the graph intersects the horizontal axis in x equal to 1 and x equal to 5. Another common form is the complete square form, a times x minus r squared plus s, where a, r and s are constants. Here a plays the same role as before, but also r and s have a clear interpretation. They are the x and y coordinate of the vertex. Our example polynomial can also be written in this form, 1/2 times x minus 3 squared minus 2. And indeed, you see that the vertex is located at 3, minus 2. What about polynomial functions of higher degree? Of course, there's always a relation between the coefficients of the shape of the graph, but this relation becomes more complicated and obscure the higher the degree gets. We can say some general things, though. It turns out that the degree is a measure of how complicated a polynomial function and its graph can be. In fact, the following is true. If you look at a graph of a polynomial function of degree n, then any straight line will intersect this graph in, at most, n points. For example, in the picture, you see the graph of a degree 4 polynomial function. Looking at several straight lines, you see that none of them intersect the graph in more than 4 points. Intuitively, you can think of it as follows. The higher the degree, the more wobbly the polynomial function may behave. Since you will encounter polynomial functions in many situations, especially linear and quadratic functions, it's very important to get a feeling for the relation between a polynomial and the shape of its graph. The exercises that follow this video will give you the opportunity to practice this. Good luck!